First, you're going to need two forms of sound output, whether you have a set of speakers and a set of headphones or two set of speakers. You're going to need more than one form of sound output. If all you got is a set of speakers, you need to go get you another set or get you a headset. Most people who use Ventrilo do have a headset and a set of speakers at the same time, so you should be good to go. What you should do is find your Ventrilo, go to properties. This right here is a shortcut, but this path is where my Ventrilo is. Right after the exe, type a space, type a hyphen, and then type an M, and that'll let you open up two copies of Ventrilo at the same time. Create you a second profile in Vent, that'll be your DJ profile. And what you're gonna do is hit this button at the bottom to mute everybody in Vent, so you don't get an endless loop of sound coming through. And just to be safe, mute yourself, not your DJ profile. Mute your main profile that you listen to the sound through, just to be safe. Then on your DJ profile, pick a place that you want the sound to come in through. It could be the speakers that you have outside of your computer, or it could be another set of speakers, whichever one you choose. And let that be your input. And your output, you could set it to a set of speakers that you have turned off so no sound will actually come through your speakers. That's what I have mine set to. I have it set to the ones that are on my desk, but they're turned off so I can't hear anything. And so when you get ready to play some music through YouTube, make sure you go to your sound properties and then set whatever you have here for your input, set that to default. If you, in this case right here on my computer, I don't have anything that says line in, but it's actually this right here. I just right click, set it to default. You can play around with it till you figure it out, and then when you play YouTube, you won't be able to hear it through your speakers directly like you used to. You will hear it through Ventrilo, and the advantage of that is you're going to be able to hear exactly what everybody else hears, so you'll know if you need to turn the volume up, down, or whatever you need to do if you got too much lag, anything like that. Now there is one disadvantage. You won't be able to, when you set another device as your default device, you won't be able to hear sound normally through anything else that you do, like if you're playing a video game. But all you really have to do, if you were playing any kind of a game or something like that, just inside the game sound options, go in there and set the sound output to whatever you want it to be, your headset or something, and then the sounds that's coming from that game won't play through Vent. It'll only be whatever you play through YouTube on your internet browser. This method works almost 100% of the time. And for some reason, this computer I got right here, it does not work on. So what I actually had to do, I had me a spare AUX cable, and these are really cheap, as you can see. You can go to the back side of your computer and plug one into the line out, and then plug the other into the line in. So the sound that your computer is putting out, it actually feeds it back into the computer, and then you can go into your sound properties and set one of them as default, which is why you saw on my DJ profile it said for the input line in. It didn't say high definition audio device speakers or anything like that, even though that is what this is right here. The computer thinks it's a set of speakers, but that's not actually what it is. On my DJ profile it says line in, so you can do it that way too, and you don't actually have to download virtual audio cable or pay for a program or anything like this. It's cheap, it's free, it's relatively inexpensive if you don't have, I mean if you have to buy this.